If you open a business and you're frustrated on a job, the reason why you're frustrated and will never get a pay raise is because you're not in His will. So when you're asking for a raise, God say, I'm not going to give you a raise because that's not the will I have for you. My will for you is to be a millionaire and own your own business. Don't even talk to me here. Here's my struggle as a pastor. I want to raise your level of thinking. Because you are so occupied in what you want to do. And you don't realize that if you get in God's will, God will pay you just for being in His will. Because, here we go, whenever you're in His will, that means you're doing what He wants you to do. And whenever I do what God wants me to do, He pays me to do what He wants me to do. He looks out for me because I'm doing what He wants me to do. Because if I'm in His will, I work for Him. And if I work for Him, all I need is my man. Look, we know that what we have, what we have asked of Him. That's what He means. If I'm in His will and I ask for it, I know it's mine. It might not come right away.
That's mine.
But it's mine. I don't have to complain and be mad and nasty. It's mine. I'm talking to every parent right now who is doing your best and faithful at your best of taking care of your children, and you're trying to figure out, God, we need more space. I need a better place to stay. God's going to tell you, if you trust Him and it's in His will, you got a new house all the way, baby. I'm talking to every person in the building right now who is struggling right now to pay your car, no, your car expenses, and you've been struggling to get oil changes, maintain your hoop debt, and pass out, have a whole lot of money. I'm being faithful over this car. I ain't looking at no car lot. I'm being faithful at this car. I'm getting it fixed when it's time to get fixed. I'm doing schedule maintenance on it. God told me to every person that needs a new car, and if it's in His will, God told me to tell you, get ready, so the keys about to be in your hand. Y'all ain't talking about you. I need somebody right now to praise God right now that I want to get in His will. God, in His will is the safest place I ever need to be. And some of you are trying to figure out, why isn't my life working? Is it working because you're not in His will? Is that working out for you because you're not in His will? Why? If you get in His will, you'll see things happen in your life that you waiting on God to do for a long time. When you get in His will, that's what it means. He's saying, here we go. His will means I finally decide to be obedient. Okay. Because your lack of obedience is hindering where He wants to take you. You're never going to prosper outside of His will. I told y'all, I was an entrepreneur and I was traveling the country doing trade shows. I remember 6-7 years ago, I did one with the department and I was selling shoes, and I made about $7,000-$8,000 in one day. And it was amazing. I would travel all around the country. I would rent U-Hauls and put the shoes in U-Haul. I would drive around the country. I was been there, all major events around the country. Bonner Brothers, everywhere you can think of, I was a vendor there. And paying Wu Friend, setting up and making thousands of dollars. And regardless of Star Transformation, I was very, very frustrated because God was doing my thing. And never forget, it was a Sunday about 2 months into Southern Church. God said, take all the shoes you have in storage and give them away. I don't know who was here then. I don't know if Anna Collier was here then or whoever was here then. She can tell you. I'm talking about close to 1,000 pairs of shoes. I just gave them away. For free. No. People were coming. Look at me. People coming from out of the community. Did you see people walking with shoe boxes to the club? There was one in the jail. I'm like, what's going on in here? I didn't say a word. I let people come all over the place, and they had to get the shoes, and look at me all, by the time it was over, all the shoes were gone. Let me tell you what that was. I had to arrest my will. Here we go. Because I knew that if I kept the shoes, I would be tempted to dive back into what I wanted to do. So in order to surrender my will, I had to disconnect myself from what was tempting me to go back and do what I wanted to do. And some of you right now, if you would stop doing your thing and do God's thing, he says, I'll bless you. The reason why some of you are broke is because you don't want to tithe. Keep being broke.
Have mercy, Lord.
I can tell you some people right now that's been right now in the service. Who got plenty of money? Yeah. There's about five people right now I know who can cut $1,000 check right now. With no problem. But they're tithers. And money comes to them like crazy. There's some people in here right now who are living a life full of peace. You know why? Because they're not outside the little block. They're locked into his will. And live a peaceful life. Who are you today? Who is outside his will? And wonder why your life doesn't work out. You know getting high isn't his will. You know getting drunk ain't his will for you. He blessed you with a temple. He blessed you with a body. And you abuse it to do your thing. But that's not his will. What am I doing in my life right now? That's not his will. You're wasting your time. You only got one life to live. And every day outside his will is another day that keeps you from purpose. Every head is about God's clothes. God, I'm praying right now for every person right now, God, who is in this building now, who is saying, God, I want to be in his will. If I'm talking to you right now, you're sick and tired of making the same mistakes over and over again, get to this altar right now. I'm waiting on you. Get out. Come on, I'm waiting on you. I'm tired of myself. I can't keep doing the same things over and over again. I did it his way. Even my personal life would be better if I did it his way. What job am I trying to force that I'm not supposed to be working? That's why I'm so frustrated on this job, because I'm not supposed to be here. I'm here because of a check. I'm at a job that's outside of his will. I'm in a relationship that's outside of his will. I am friends with somebody. It's not his will. Yeah, at the altar right now. Lift your hands right now. Come on, open your mouth. Come on. Come on, open your mouth. Come on. Come on. Come on, in the name of Jesus. In your will is the safest place I need to be. I make mistakes, God. I fumble the ball. I do things, God, I shouldn't do. But God, I really, really want to be in your will. Because, God, being in your will protect me.